With all the recent moves that the OKC Thunder have been pulling off, it's becoming more and more apparent that the franchise is entering into previously uncharted territory. And all thanks to the PG and Russell Westbrook trades, General Manager Sam Presti is more than equipped to push the organization into creating the next elite Thunder team with an unprecedented draft war chest. Right now, the Thunder own about 15 first-round picks and about 4 pick swaps and counting, which covers the next 6 NBA drafts. Yeah, it's that massive. And for real, the NBA hasn't seen a draft haul this big ever in the league's history, and you can immediately tell that the Thunder are just a few drafts away from finding legit studs to support their young core. While it's always easy to assume that most of the first round picks which they have acquired would only land in the late or mid first rounds. But if you look at it realistically, the Houston Rockets appear to be blowing it all up pretty soon, and for the Clippers, PG and Kawhi are locked up with the team only until 2021, and anything can definitely happen after that. But yeah, right now, it's really hard to project what those stockpiles of picks mean or what exactly is the right thing to do with it moving forward. But if there's any indication of where this team is headed, who they pick in the recently concluded 2020 NBA draft will definitely tell you a lot, and that's what we're about to look at here. So what's good guys, it's Rerobolz, and in this video, we'll take a look at two of the Thunder's recent draft night acquisitions, Aleksej Pokusevski and Theo Maledon, and we'll dig deep at how Sam Presti has jump-started possibly the best rebuild plan in NBA history. Let's get to it. Well yeah, I'm a Thunder fan, and if there's any league executive that I would trust to orchestrate a rebuild, it's definitely Sam Presti. Well, if you look at it, during his 13 seasons as OKC's general manager, the guy only picked in the lottery a total of 7 times, but with that, he was still able to land 3 future MVPs, a budding young all-star in Sabonis, and a solid starting caliber big man in Steven Adams. Plus, under his leadership, OKC was also able to find late first-round gems such as Serge Ibaka, Reggie Jackson, and Andre Roberson. So yeah, just imagine what this guy could do with 15 first-round picks and counting. And if you look at other recent rebuilds in the league, well, most notably the Philadelphia 76ers process, aka the most notorious tank job in NBA history, you'll see that it took their team multiple seasons of losing and conscious tanking in order for them to acquire a total of 10 first-round picks in 7 drafts. But in the case of OKC, they have been able to instantly acquire 8 first-round picks in just a week after dealing PG to the Clippers and Russ to the Rockets. So yeah, you can see how OKC is in a much better position. But honestly, I don't even think the Thunder have to purposely lose to get better in the future. Because with all this draft capital that they have, there's always the possibility of trading for another disgruntled star from another team. And of course, there's also the very enticing potential of player development from guys like SGA, Darius Bazley, Lu Dort, and these guys which they have acquired in the recently concluded draft. Well, first, there's Aleksej Pokusevski, an 18-year-old 7-foot Serbian-Greek forward who has been playing professionally for Greek club Olympiakos since he was 17. This kid is the height of a big man, the playmaking and handles of a point guard, and the perimeter skill set of an NBA wing. Well, there were a number of draft sites which projected this kid to have most potential out of all rookies in this 2020 draft class, and a number of mock drafts really projected OKC to select this kid. And I think this pick is definitely going to be one heck of a steal in the long run. And why do I say that? Well, for starters, we haven't seen a 7-footer who's had this rare combination of size, handles, and perimeter skill set ever before. You'd actually think that this kid came straight out of the lab because considering that he's that tall, his ability to control the ball, to shoot, and his ability to run the breaks on offense doesn't necessarily take a step back. And also, combine all of that with his high basketball IQ and high-level passing, and it's safe to assume that this kid will just be a solid NBA player moving forward. Well, a lot of people are comparing him to Kristaps Porzingis, but I don't necessarily see that. Well, yeah, okay, they're both super tall big men who are listed as forwards who can both shoot from anywhere on the floor and can also handle the ball. But the difference is, Porzingis didn't really run the floor and carry the ball coast to coast like this kid does. Well, the obvious difference is basically Pokusevski's unique ability to fully coordinate his movements in the full court despite his 7-foot frame. Well, same as with young prospects and rookies, this kid isn't the finished product, but still, you pretty much get the picture. This kid is actually listed as either a small forward or a power forward, but if you look at it, he basically plays like a shooting guard or even a point guard. Well, obviously the kid still needs to bulk up for him to be able to take contact on the NBA level, and that is of course an area of concern. But we've seen skinny guys transform their bodies and hold their own upon entering the NBA, and that goes for Pokusevski as well. And if you look at the defensive side of things, this kid isn't projected to be elite defensively at least for now, but just as scouts have pointed out his instincts and basketball IQ, I think it's safe to assume that he will still be a good team defender if incorporated into a good defensive scheme. And well, this kid already played professional basketball for a Greek club since he was 17, and during the 2019-2020 season, just prior to him entering the draft, Pokusevski averaged 10.8 points, 7.9 rebounds, 3 assists, 1.3 steals, and 1.3 blocks per game while only playing 23 minutes per game. Well, he only shot 40% from the field and 32% from deep. But considering that this kid was constantly taking the ball down the court like a point guard and was taking difficult shots while playing against much older players in the pro league, it's safe to assume that Pokusevski will just get better on both ends of the floor as he gets more experience on a legit NBA system. Well, it's kind of hard to predict his ceiling right now, and it's just not right to call him the next KD or something, in my opinion. But I totally get why Sam Presti wanted this kid so bad. Pokusevski is just a rare find nowadays, and yeah, why not? Might as well gamble on something as unique as him, right? Well, moving on, the Thunder also got French point guard Theo Maledon in the second round. Well, to me, this kid is another steal and is just one of the more underrated point guards from this draft class. Yeah, he doesn't appear to be as flashy as LaMelo Ball or Killian Hayes, but it's really hard not to see this kid's abilities while playing professionally in France. Well, I really wanted the Thunder to select this kid if he happened to slip down in the draft, and I'm really glad that they had a chance to acquire him at number 34. So yeah, Theo Maledon is a 6'5 lead guard with a 6'8 wingspan who plays like a traditional point guard, but he has exceptional size and physical tools which would allow him to play as a combo guard in the NBA level, just like SGA. Well, this kid made his pro debut in France for basketball club Asphalt when he was just 16 years old, and just a year after, during the 2018-2019 season, he became the youngest player ever to be selected to the French League All-Star Game, and during that same season, he won the MVP award in the French Cup Finals. And in the recently concluded 2019-2020 season, Maledon averaged 7.3 points, 2.7 assists, and 1.9 rebounds per game while playing 7.3 minutes per game. Well, you'd notice that his numbers aren't outstanding at first glance, but it's not that hard to figure out that in Europe, basketball isn't all about the statistics but more of getting wins and playing team basketball. So right by the get-go, you'll see that this kid has already thrived in a professional environment while competing against much older players. Well, a lot of scouts have noticed Maledon to be a very mature point guard, citing his great feel for the game. This kid mostly plays at a very controlled pace, but he does possess a deceptive quick first step when attacking the hoop, and he has also excellent footwork which helps him blow by defenses. Well, he's also got a solid shooting form, but I think he definitely needs to develop a quicker release if he's going to be a reliable shooter in the NBA. Well, Maledon isn't necessarily superb as a scorer, but he's a pretty solid guy who can also score at all three levels. So the potential is definitely there for this kid, and I'd definitely take that for a second round pick. While as a primary playmaker and ball handler at 6'5", Maledon creates the right plays because of his excellent court vision and precision passing. And his playmaking ability is the skill which I think will most likely translate to the NBA level pretty quickly. And on the defensive end, this kid has solid lateral quickness, and he also has the length to be able to guard multiple positions on the floor. And you can just count on him to be able to effectively defend stronger guards once he gets his body fully developed. While a lot of people have been comparing Maledon to Tony Parker, well, they're both French and they both attended the same basketball training academy, but aside from that and their playmaking ability, I don't think there are that many similarities in their games. But yeah, there's always that possibility that Sam Presti really saw some Tony Parker in this kid. Because if you're not aware, Sam Presti is known to have played a crucial role in influencing the Spurs to select Parker late in the first round when Presti was still working for the Spurs in 2001. Well, obviously, Maledon is a much bigger and much longer version of Parker if ever, but it's too early to say if this kid will be just as good as him. But I honestly think that this kid has the potential to be a solid two-way NBA player in the near future. And with OKC's choices in this recent draft, you might be wondering if this trend will continue in the future. Is Presti intentionally going the overseas route in trying to rebuild the Thunder? Well, it's easy to assume that going the European or overseas route is a very viable option with the recent emergence of Luka Doncic and the unlikely discovery of Giannis a few years back. While this may be a real possibility, but for now, what the Thunder have is actually pretty good for a rebuilding team if you ask me. Well, if anything, I can somehow compare OKC's rebuilding situation with the scenario that the Celtics had when they traded Kevin Garnett and Paul Pierce to Brooklyn in 2013. The Celtics basically built their current roster through a stockpile of picks which they acquired from that trade. And they were able to somehow be competitive during the Isaiah Thomas years while they were preparing for their turn to acquire guys through the draft. While they got Marcus Smart, Jaylen Brown, they used some of their picks to land Kyrie, and in the end, it was worth the wait as in 2017, they finally landed their long-awaited star which turned out to be Jason Tatum. I think OKC is in a very similar place right now, but the only difference is, even before using their massive haul of picks, the Thunder have already found their guy. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander already arrived as soon as Sam Presti was trying to finesse the Clippers for picks. But is he already the crown jewel of this Thunder rebuild? Well, yeah, for now he is. But with young stars emerging out of the blue every now and then, we just never know. But what's for sure is that the Thunder have all the assets imaginable to create a team that will contend for a very long time. OKC is practically set up for the rest of the decade, but honestly, I don't even think they will be able to draft another KD, Westbrook, or Harden, and that's not really a bad thing. We can't even tell what it would take for this team to win a championship, but with all the picks that he has acquired, you better believe that Sam Presti already has the championship blueprint in his mind. We just don't know what it looks like yet, but we're going to find out pretty soon. Thank you guys for sticking until the end of the video, and I just want to give a quick shout out to the entire Thunder Nation around the world. And feel free to drop a comment below about what you think of the Thunder rebuild. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please smash that like button because it helps the channel a lot to be noticed by other fans around the NBA YouTube community. Also, please do subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet because you don't want to miss another fire NBA content which I put out regularly. Again, this is Rerobolz, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace!